monster yelling at him. Will he survive or not? The choppy waves carried me along the magnificent Arabian Sea. I opened the deck of my sailing boat to search for my bag, which contained my breakfast. As I was about to remove fresh sandwich, I suddenly slipped and my bag fell in the choppy waters. I was sad at the sunless sea. Then suddenly I found a gigantic island a few hundred meters away from me. I could see that it had emerald green trees and pine green bushes. After reaching there, I drank coconut water, ate an apple, a pear, and some berries. Then I went to explore the beauty of the island. I found interesting wildlife like bees, deers, and elephants. In addition to it, I also found a breathtaking cave. With every bit of my courage, I decided to go in. As soon as I went in, a tremendously big rock fell out of nowhere and blocked the entrance. And I suddenly realized that I forgot to light a flambeau. Yet, I had a mini torch in my pocket, which helped me. The torch was got on, and to my surprise, I found ancient and dilapidated statues and carvings in a language out of my knowledge. How I wish there was network in this cave. I could have googled it and knew what is it. Yet I wonder, doesn't Google know about this cave? So here I was, all alone in a lonely, deserted place in the middle of nowhere. Even with the best of technology in my hand, I was helpless. I wondered what other creature could be living in this extraordinary cave. Could there be huge hairy spiders, or monsters, or ghosts, or some unimaginable creature? But thinking about it, my head stood on edge. Suddenly, I found scarlet red eyes of a monster googling at me. I was so horrified that I started running. Not knowing the cave was so extensive, I kept running. Then all of a sudden, I saw a beam of light at a distance. I tried running faster, but the monster caught me by the leg and fell on the rocky ground of the cave, hitting my head. While I was trying to get a hold of a thick woody branch, the monster bit my calf and I screamed so loudly that the monster seemed to cover his ears. Finally, I got hold of the thick woody branch and hit with all of my might on the monster's head. The monster left my leg at an instant. Though being wounded, I left the cave with all my might. And to my relief, I came out in the hot scorching sun. When I looked back to see where the monster was still following me, and to my surprise, I saw that the monster was at the exit point but did not come out in the sun. I thought that the monster was habituated to stay in the dark, that maybe it was afraid to step out in the bright light. After that, I went far away from the cave and realized we should remain calm and confident when in danger, especially in escaping the dark cave.